Hi, my name is Tim Coleman. I'm with Augusta Aquatics, and today I wanted to show you some of the differences that quality can make, or a lack of quality can make. Many times you hear the phrase, you get what you pay for, and we're here at a home in a very nice section of Charlottesville, Virginia, at a concrete pool that is 6 years old. And unfortunately, we're with the third homeowner of this particular house, and this is a concrete pool that was built by a competitor. And this competitor is typically a low bid. And I wanted to point out some of the things that have gone wrong with this pool and why they have caused these things to go wrong, and some of the things that you should look for in a quality contractor to build your concrete pool. First thing I want to point out is that this pool is 6 years old, and this pool is 18 by 40. It's a rectangle, and this has an automatic cover, an automated cover. This particular homeowner has been here for, I think, a year or maybe 18 months, and has already had to replace the cover. Now, fortunately, they did get a quality automatic cover company, one that we deal with. We deal with two or three, but this one in particular is a very high quality, very reputable firm, and have replaced the pool cover. But really the reason why we're videotaping this is we want to point out some of the defects that we've found in this pool. The homeowner called us up and asked us to come out and give them a price on fixing some tile that had fallen off and some coping stones that were loose. And that's why we're here. We've gone ahead and secured the contract, we've taken off the coping and we've taken off the tile, but we're going to show you some of the things that we discovered in that process. If you look over here, you can see that you've got a deck surface. And then this is an expansion joint material, which is very appropriate for this application. There's usually a caulking on top, and there was caulking in this case, and it was actually in pretty good shape and intact. This expansion foam, in this case it's 4 inches tall, and it's a half inch wide, sits something like this so that it is straight up and down when done properly. Because when they shoot or form the concrete pool, they take a band board. In our case, we use a board that's a 1x6, and we form it so it's straight up and down, and that gives whoever shooting the concrete a nice clean edge when they're done. We also put in something we call a deck ledge that helps support the deck, but we'll get to that in a moment. In this case, it doesn't look like they used any forming, that they just merely dug the hole and shot concrete in as best they could. The problem with that is that this is a 14-inch coping, and you need at least 12 inches of good material to set this coping on. Well, because they didn't form it, there was this void behind you. We have about 8 inches from the front face to back here for which this coping was sitting on. Because there was no form straight up and down, the concrete, when they shot it, actually went back. And this was before the deck was here. And they didn't clean that edge up or put a nice edge in there for this to set up against. Well, they also did make it very tall when they did that. And as you can see, we can remove pieces of concrete from the back. This is Emma. Say hi to Emma. So you can see that this was all loose material. And what has happened in this case, as you can see, they didn't put any gravel underneath this deck. You've got red clay, which holds water, and it does look like they put in maybe an inch of mason sand behind it, and that could have been there from either the gunite, the coping and tile process, or something like that. But there's no gravel. And the end result here, the end result here is that in the wintertime, water is going to get underneath this deck. This pool beam is like a foundation or a footer on your house. This isn't supposed to move. If it's not thick enough in the back, it'll move, it'll crack, and you'll get things like this, especially if there's nothing to carry the water away underneath. That coping, this material here, is sitting on top of this. 14 inches wide, so this much of it is sitting on basically wet sand that's going to freeze, and red clay, which is going to hold the water. The purpose of the wash gravel underneath the deck is to carry that water away, or help wick that water away from underneath the deck to help prevent it from rising from freeze thaw conditions. In this case, it didn't have that. As a result of this ground heaving or moving, it lifted up the back of the stone, and this coping was loose. A full 12 inches for a 14-inch coping. You can put at the deck edge ledge in here underneath to help support the deck. You put in a good expansion material, and you have a nice clean edge. You've got to have that 4 inches of minimum of gravel underneath of this to wick that water away from this pool deck. All right, so here we are again. We're talking about what happens when you don't do a good job when you're building the pool. In this particular project, the coping stone was sitting on sand and red clay, which holds the water. In the wintertime, that freezes and then thaws and freezes again. In the process of freezing, that water is expanding, and it merely just popped this coping up and created it, made it loose from its mud bed here. Well, in the process of making the coping loose, it also pulled the tile off. In this particular case, when they applied the tile, they didn't make a nice smooth bed for that tile to sit on and then apply a thin quality thin set material and then put the tile on. They took a 6x6 tile, had a wheelbarrow in here, and they plopped a daub of mud on it and they stuck it up, which if we come over here, we can take a look, you can see what happened. Here's the daub of mud. They slap the tile up here and they move on to the next one. Well, you can see the darker brown area is, that was hollow. They came back and they grouted it in, so you didn't see, the homeowner doesn't see it, but that hollow exists. Water wicks in from the back because water is part of nature and nature does things. And water came in behind this void. Of course, if there was a not a good seal in that grout or between the plaster and this, water got in behind here. And because these corners were hollow, it freeze thaw cycles, it caused that tile to pop right off. The best way to do it is to have a nice even bed all the way across, put a thin set up so that your tile has contact with cement the whole way and there's no voids. That's the way you do it right. When your concrete pool builder is building your pool and he's actually shooting the gunite or the shotcrete, one of the things that he needs to take special attention to is the skimmer box. This is the skimmer box. This is the weir. This floats up and down, and actually when the water level is up here, and that's what actually cleans the surface of the pool. But this is a plastic housing, and you're embedding it in concrete, or you're surrounding it with concrete. In this particular case, after we've removed the coping and tile from this project, because of some other workmanship practices that were actually poor, we discovered this. That's a nice sizable hole that goes to right into the ground, and your water level is typically right here. So you can see that if I can stick my thumb in there, it's more than just a dike. This is a large leak in this particular pool. If my cameraman can, you can see that there's actually hollows underneath this housing as well. So what has to happen is when the person is doing the gunite or the shotcrete, while it's still fresh and wet, they actually need to pack underneath the bottom here as well as the sides. And then the tile mason needs to come in and he needs to pack again these areas with some white cement to help seal it. In this particular case, neither one wasn't done, and I guarantee you this pool leaked.
All right.
Okay, we're looking at this particular pool. It's a concrete pool, 18x40, has an automatic cover. And Emma, the family doll, will be running around. So that's who you see running around. That's Emma. Say hi to Emma. This particular pool has a single main drain. When this pool was built 6 years ago, single main drains were technically allowed. The Virginia Graham Baker Act of, let's say, is 2007, signed by President George Bush, outlawed this type of installation. The problem with a single main drain is if you manipulate the valves at the equipment pad a certain way, all the suction for the pool pump is on this one device. So if you happen to be swimming by and you have long hair, or you're sizable like myself and you lay on top of this thing, it would pull you down tight to this drain or entangle your hair in the grate, so you'd be trapped underwater. The Virginia Graham Baker Act says that you do some corrective or preventative measures to forego this. One would be to put in dual main drains, which is something I've been doing in Augusta Aquatics since we started. And even before that, our trade has said do it for at least the last 15 years since the mid-90s. And that says if you have your plumbing in the center, or your T, and you have equal distances, if somebody's laying on top of this grate, well, then the pump is going to pull from the grate over here. In this particular case, since there's only one grate, you're stuck. So in this case, what we're going to do with this pool is we're going to put a device in the pump. Should it register a suction entrapment issue, it's going to turn off the pump or allow air into the system, breaking that suction and letting the person escape. Something else about this particular pool and its construction, if you look on the bottom of this pot, you can see that there's actually two manufactured holes in the sump. I'm going to try and keep my hat out of your way here. There's this one on the bottom, and there's one on the side. The one on the side goes to the pool pump, and the one on the bottom, in this particular case, when we emptied this pool, it had a plug in it. Well, the way a pool is built, it doesn't matter if it's fiberglass or concrete, it's basically a structure, like a boat. And if there was sufficient groundwater around this pool with a plug in it, then as we took the water out of the pool and it was on the outside perimeter, that groundwater would cause this pool to literally pop out of the ground like a boat and float. So the first thing that we did as we emptied the pool, first we ran the water a good distance away from the pool, and we did it slowly. We didn't do it really fast, and as soon as we could, we got to the bottom to make sure that there was not a plug in here, but a device called a hydrostat, which is a check valve, which will allow groundwater to enter and seal as the pool water is in the pool. So it's like a check valve, and it protects the bottom of the pool. In this particular case, we're going to go ahead and put a hydrostat in and replace that plug, which that was literally going to destroy this pool.